Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Great Plains Lutheran High School. We're glad that you can join us this afternoon. The percussion ensemble that you just heard just performed at the Region Music Contest. Did I get that correctly? And they just did that to get us warmed up for our concert this afternoon. I hope you all know, as I welcome you here this afternoon, for those of you who are here in person and those of you who are watching and listening online, that this year our theme is Run with Perseverance, based on Hebrews chapter 12, the opening verses. And it's our hope, our prayer this afternoon, that the concert that you hear, as you hear the music, as you hear the words which are sung and proclaimed, that this concert this afternoon will help you to do just that, to run with perseverance the race marked out for you, as we're encouraged to do that. And the writer of Hebrews encourages us, as we do that, to fix our eyes on Jesus. So again, it's our hope and our prayer that this concert helps each one of you to do that, to fix your eyes on Jesus, and as a subset, so to speak, of running with perseverance, to make a joyful noise to the Lord. God bless you this afternoon.
Thank you. I'm going to take a moment for a couple of announcements, and while I do that, you're free to stand. So why don't you all stand, and I'm going to keep talking, and just I want to thank a couple of individuals. There were lots of words in the program, and it was either another page or try to remember everything, so I'm going to try to remember everything. A huge thank you to the students. We just had Region Solo Ensemble Contest a couple of weeks ago. This is just a couple of the solos and ensembles that performed. Probably, I think we had maybe 40 entries or so at that contest. So a huge thank you to the students for participating in that. But I want to take a moment and thank Mrs. Rosenthal, Dee Dee Rosenthal, for accompanying us on our last piece. That's yet to happen, so please join me in thanking her. Because it will be great. It was a kind of a last minute ask, and so I really appreciate the time and all the work that she was willing to put into that. And thank you to my wife Deanna for accompanying and coming in and helping us get prepared too. So thank you. And an individual that's new in our department, Ms. Kutia, if you would stand. She will be our student teacher for the next 8 weeks, 9 weeks. I can't remember what's left. So she'll be around. So if you hear the students talking about her, that's who we got. So thank you so much. You can have a seat and we will continue with the choir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you to the students for all of your work. Thank you for your preparation and your time. Sickness and trying to get the ensembles all together at 100% for a practice. Sometimes it's a little bit of a challenge, but I appreciate all the work that the students put into it. So thank you again so much. And for the extra instrumentalists, again, limited rehearsal time, getting things together with schedules and whatnot. We have busy kids, and it's great and it's amazing, and I'm so thankful to have the opportunity to be in front of them to make music in praise to our God and for your enjoyment. So thank you.
Just going to again take this opportunity to thank you for coming to our concert this afternoon. It's our prayer that the joyful noise that you heard will uplift you as you continue your Lenten journey to the cross and to the empty tomb of our Savior on Easter. Would like to echo some of the words of thanks that Mr. Martins already said and then add a couple to that list as well. First of all, Mr. Martins, thank you for all your work. Let's give him a round of applause. We can't underestimate how much time goes into everything that he pulls together to make this possible. We very much appreciate it. Also, our student teacher, Elsie Cotilla, for directing a song, Pastor Ken Nelson for working with the strings, and then again, our accompanists, Deanna Martins and Dee Dee Rosenthal. Let's thank them all again as well. By all means, stick around and mingle. We will maybe in 10 to 15 minutes from now try to transition over to the north end of the gym for our winter awards banquet. If you could help a little bit, some of these folding chairs will need to be moved over as well so that we have enough place for everybody to sit and eat later. Again, thank you for coming this afternoon. May Jesus bless your travel home. Thank you.
put in a significant amount of work. They had a lot of lines. And we really appreciate the work that they did to anchor the play and kind of bring it all together. One of the judges said their favorite moment all day was a scene that they shared. And I agree with that. I thought it was a fantastic performance. And so our MVP award goes to Caleb Roberts and Lydia Cross. That does it for one act. It has been a blessing to be a part of this for 13 years. I look forward to where it goes. We will be graduating one senior off of the team. That will be Caleb. So we'll have hopefully a strong showing next year, and I look forward to a drama.
I'm very grateful for the person that's about to come up here and talk to you about cheerleading, because several months ago in the fall, we didn't have a cheerleaders coach, and I didn't know what we were going to do. And so I kind of contacted her out of the blue, basically saying, hey, someone told me you might like to do this for us, and she said, sure, even though she's extremely busy with a whole lot of other things. So to talk to you about the cheerleaders, Coach Jenna Johnson.
To speak to our successes this year. So So here is the 2019-2020 cheerleading five numbers. And starting with the number seven, we have seven girls on this team, and I'll speak more about them later. But this group of girls is the top reason why this season was so great. Number six, we learned six new sideline cheers this year. That brings our total up to 21 sidelines and five crowd cheers. Now that involves memorizing words and actions and doing it in synchronicity with all the other members of the team. So it is not necessarily an easy task, but these girls made it look easy. Number five, we have five sophomores in the group, one senior, one freshman. Coincidentally, we also have five veterans on the team, and two of them cheering for the first time this year. Number four, we learned at least four major stunts that went into our dance routine this year. That included kicks, splits, flips. This required a lot of practice, pairing up the right people, and getting over a few fears of falling. Number three, we learned three band dances this year, and hopefully you guys saw that along the sidelines. They were a lot of fun to do. Thank you to Mr. Martins for coordinating with us to get the music and making that happen with us. Number two, 2 minutes and 50 seconds was the length of our halftime dance routine. It was so much fun to see how that all came together, the extra work that the girls put in, even without me there. This is my absolute favorite accomplishment of the season. And number one, last game of the year, we had one major wardrobe malfunction. Hopefully nobody noticed. It was something that will stick in my mind. It makes me smile every time I think of it. You girls are awesome. I want to talk a little bit about each of the girls. I'll introduce them, and they can stand. And then I want to talk about them each individually. Andrea Lubayek, Daisy Holloway, Madeline Ramsey, Jenna Lindemann, Starla Hedman, Brooke Lamley, and Sammy Bendix. So let's give them a quick round of applause. Thank you. So I'm going to start with Andrea because she's our only senior this year. Andrea was incredibly calm, go with the flow, reliable, and an excellent communicator. She always reached out to me whenever she had questions or needed something. Daisy was very detail-oriented. She picked things up quickly because she had a little bit of cheer experience in the past, and I think she can really be a powerhouse going into future seasons. Madeline was absolutely the most improved. She worked really hard, and it showed how important it is to really do well and to try. Jenna, she has the technicalities. She's sharp, she's loud, she's got good timing. And she was absolutely the most adventurous and willing to try stunts first. Starla was laid back. She kept everyone calm. She never got worked up when people didn't know what was going on, and she grounded everybody. The last two girls I'm going to describe as I'm giving them their awards. So I'm giving the Panther Award to Brooke. Brooke is kind-hearted, a mediator, a We threw a lot of things together quickly, like Mr. Hobley said. There was a lot of spur-of-the-moment things and a lot of things that I didn't even know had to be done. And so it was very helpful and necessary to have a veteran like Sammy there to help us along with all of those things. So MVP, Sammy Bendix. Andrea, I wish you the absolute best wherever life takes you next. To the rest of you, I hope I see you again next season. Thank you.
Our final group for the evening is boys basketball. And so to talk to you about boys basketball, Coach Wall. I'm kidding. You gotta get the new guy. It wasn't until about Thursday of last week that I specifically told you don't need to prepare anything for tonight. So he would have though. He would have probably said next play about 13 times. And yeah. Like Mr. Bauer said with the girls' basketball, I have some thank yous that I would like to take care of at first. And the first two are transporters, well, Coach Bauer for doubleheaders, and Carla for our boys-only games. Significant thank you for getting us safely to all the places throughout the, well, beyond even the borders of our state here this season. I would also like to say a special thank you to everybody that was involved in the event up at Trinity. Even though we had to deal with rescheduling, I know that's primarily Al Jensen, but I know there's a lot of other people that were a big contributor to making that event against North Central a success. Logistics were kind of crazy with all that, but it was a great experience, so thanks to everybody, especially the happening people that made that possible. I'd like to thank the cheerleaders for bringing the energy this year. We just highlighted them. I'd also like to thank our fans. Where's Jackson? Is he gone? Okay, I'll have to catch him in the hall tomorrow. Thanks, Jackson, for being one of our leaders in the student section. And thanks to all the students that were part of it. As Mr. Bauer said, there was more energy in the student section throughout the year. We gave them more things to cheer about this year, which was a lot of fun, obviously. But home field matters. Home court matters in high school. And when I reflect on the season, when we performed our best, it usually was here in front of you guys, and you were a part of that. So thank you. I'd also like to thank my wife. As Mr. Bauer said, it's a lot of time, and we've been doing this now for a few years. Of me being involved with basketball throughout the winter. It makes my winter go real fast, but that's because I'm in a different town every night. So thanks to my wife for holding down the fort, keeping our dog occupied. I appreciate you, I love you. Aww, she's my wife. She's in the back, she's blushing. I'd like to introduce the team members first, so when I say your name, stand up, and we'll recognize all of them at the end. Freshman, Cole Bendix. Oh, I should also say, after I name some of these people, they're going to be, I will read off some kind of funny awards that our team voted on. All of our awards were selected by votes by the team members. It'll make sense as we go through it. Cole Bendix, Joe Dahlberg, Levi Holloway, RJ Perry, Ethan Russell. Ethan got a couple of awards. Mr. Clean for the best one on the boards, rebounder, and Mr. Spin Cycle for the best post moves. Parker Watkins, I believe that's the freshman, so sophomores, Gavin Dornbush, Joe Erickson, Robbie Goins, Elijah Grahams, Sam Hansen, Sam won Mr. Vice Grip, triple threat. Connor Canass, Ethan Jenstead, who won Mr. Future Coach. You can come take my job. Ryan Kuhlman, Trent Lean, juniors, Austin Adams, Nathan Bean, who won Mr. Black and Blue. Nolan Hansen, Andrew Heil, who won two Mr. Handles, Best Dribbler, and Mr. Sniper. Pierce Olin, Colin Yeager, James Kim, Logan Lossing, Martin Rosh, and Goki Tsuchida. Did I get it? All right. No, Tsuchida. Okay, closer. Seniors, Asher Lindemann. Asher won two awards, Mr. Florburn and Mr. Nat, G-N-A-T, for the most annoying on-ball defender. David Lubaya. Chris Schlecht also won Mr. Nat. It was a tie. And Joe Tischer, who won Mr. Encourager and Mr. Boxout. And our two managers this year, Stephanie Van Veen and Kylie Lausing. Your 2019-2020 basketball team. I'd like to take a minute to talk about our lower levels first. C team, this year we had several boys playing on C team. Some played C team and JV, some just played C team. We were able to get 7 games plus a tournament on a Saturday. C games are hard to get because we can only do them when it's just a boys game, and it has to be against an opponent that also has the numbers to have a C team. And quite frankly, not many do. The fact that we were able to get at least one game in most of the weeks between Christmas and the end of the season made me pretty happy with the flow. And I have to give a huge thank you to Mr. Klanke. He's up there. Mr. Klanke decided to give some of his free time to help Mr. Wall with our lower levels. He didn't have to do it. It wasn't part of his original obligation when he came to our school this year, but he helped us out. Probably helps that he and Mr. Wall are good friends. But I'm really appreciative of both of them for the work that they put in with the C team and helped them grow along the way. And C team is a level that's an interesting level. Over the course of the years, I've had players that have gone from C team to be varsity contributors by the time that it's all said and done. So skills, practice, and lessons learned at that level can be a huge thing to a program. And so I'm thankful for our two coaches that put time in with them, and I'm thankful for the boys that played C team this year. On the JV, I asked Coach Wall to do something that was nearly impossible for even a seasoned coach, let alone a coach doing it for the first time. You get 24 minutes in the game, you have 18 boys. Figure it out. We had 18 boys suit up for many of our JV games. What an insane proposition. Let's try to find the appropriate playing time, to find the right roles, to find any type of cohesion throughout the year is a significant task. That being said, I saw boys learning. I heard boys learning. During most of the JV games, I would sit right behind them. Pretty much right behind where I'm standing right now. And you could hear them having conversations on the bench about a thing that happened on the court, whether it was the right situation or the right decision or the right call, or it was just there's basketball happening in games. And then in practices, I can't begin to express how wonderful it is to know that while I'm on one side of the gym working with the varsity, I know that the other side is getting good basketball instruction. And Coach Wall specifically, he brought energy to every single practice, and if you watch any of our games, he brings the energy, okay? Sometimes I thought I'd have to get him some water just to get his voice back. And if the boys didn't learn anything else from Coach Wall this year, which I know they did, at least they learned, boys, next play. Next play, next play, next play. So thank you, Coach Wall and Coach Lanky, for your work with the JV boys and all the boys that play JV. Thank you for your hard work throughout the season as well. Heading into this season for the varsity, I knew that there was going to be a significant step forward just because of how many kids were coming back from last year's team. And I know what last year was, and I know that I asked so many of them to take on roles at the varsity level that they just quite weren't ready for yet. We threw them into the fire and the results were what they were. But I knew that that experience would help them as these young men continued to grow physically and with the experience that they received last year. I also knew that this event so close to the finish of the season, I'm still processing how things went. A week ago right now, we were practicing, getting ready for our playoff game against Britt Macklin. And now here we are. So I'm trying to put something eloquent together for us this evening. When I looked at the schedule, our schedule is very competitive. Our region in Class B is the most competitive region in the entire state. And I wouldn't want it any other way. I told the boys this in the locker room. Tough competition makes us better. It might not help our record this year, but it will make us better. And I truly believe that. As a point of record, one team almost had the exact opposite record of us. We were 4-16, they were something very opposite of that. But their combined record of opponents was like negative 120, whereas ours was well over 500. So our competition was very tough this year. As I look back on the year, there are some really fun highlights that I'd like to share with you this evening. The first being at the beginning of the year, getting to go to Martin Luther College to play two different Wells high schools. We played Evergreen Lutheran out of Seattle, and then Nebraska Lutheran out of Waco. And we were able to come away with our first win of the season, and for many of the boys sitting here today, it was their first varsity win. And that was a fun moment for the boys, and a sign of things that we could do together as a team. As mentioned before, when we went up to Aberdeen, what a fun atmosphere, what a fun night. It was one of those nights where I start to see our team believe that they can do things because we overcame a double-digit deficit and turned it into a double-digit win. And that was a lot of fun to see the people up in Aberdeen come out and support us and for us to put on a good game for them as well. Other highlights include back-to-back wins here at home against teams that just last year beat us by the 30-point mercy rule. So that's a significant change. That was a lot of fun. Aside from those wins, we had plenty of games where we were right there, competitive towards the end of the game, just didn't fall our way. But hopefully that experience will help this program in the future as we're in those positions moving forward on a regular basis. Perhaps the most thrilling of all of them was the last one right here against Wilmot, which ended in overtime with a close game. This season specifically, I'm very thankful for my final assistant coach to be mentioned here, which is Coach Schrader. Victor Schrader decided to help us out, even though he is a very busy man himself with bickering over at St. Martin's. And his abilities and his expertise were essential for us this year as we implemented a new style of offense that he did in high school and really helped the team. It was great to have him as another set of eyes. Obviously, he couldn't be here every day because of his other obligations. But the days that he could come were great. The games that he was able to make and the insights that he was able to give on the sideline were great. And Coach, God's blessings to you next year at seminary. God's blessings on being a father for the first time. We're looking forward to that. And we'll keep your huddle account active so you can watch all the fun next year. Thanks, Coach. As I said, I'm really trying to process everything still since we're so close to the end of the season. And I'm going to try to do what I call the grandparent view of the season. What I mean by that is if you're the parent of your child's growing up, maybe you don't see the growth that grandparents see when they only see you from here to a couple months down the road or whatever it is. Because as I try to do that and think about where we were 3 months ago, a lot has changed. A lot has changed. It's incredible for me to see how much our team has grown. One of the things I tell the boys every year is that the March version of ourselves had better destroy the December version of ourselves. And we talked about that as we were winding down the year, and I fully believe that. We would be so much better, we are so much better than we were at the beginning of the year. And I think the real big thing for this team was something that happened about the middle of the season, where everything just started to gel. The team's cohesion just really started to become evident, primarily in the offensive side of the ball. And I have a couple of stats that just kind of show how much different the second half of the year was to the first half. Just in the statistic of turnovers, we hate turnovers. It's really hard to imagine that there was a game this year, guys, where we had 37 in a game in households. Yeah, they're cringing because of it. Many of our games towards the end were single digits. We cut down our average in turnovers from the first half to the second half by 9 a game. That's 9 times that we get to score that we didn't get to in the first half. And it led to us scoring more consistently. We increased our points per game by 8 in the second half of the year. That gives you a chance to win. the season to end, but even more so this year because I felt like the team was figuring themselves out. They had established their roles and they were starting to gel together as a team. Certainly we were competing much more consistently, albeit we had some rough moments at times throughout the end of the season still. I would like to now announce our letter winners for this year. Our letter winners, and you guys can all stand and we'll recognize you once this is done. Asher Lindemann, Chris Schlecht, Joe Tischer, Nathan Bean, Andrew Heil, Logan Lossing, Martin Rausch, Sam Hansen, Ethan Jenstedt, and Ethan Russell, our letter winners. You guys can sit down, thanks. By the way, all certificates are in my room. You can pick them up at the end. I would like to take a moment to recognize each of our four seniors and say a word about them. I'm going to start with David. Stand up, David. We're going to embarrass you. David's been with us for 2 years. He came as a junior. Did you know anything about basketball when you got here? Nope, didn't think so. But he learned to love it. He learned to love being a part of our team. He was a big part of our JV. A lot of times, coach put him at the top of the 1-3-1 zone to be energetic, get steals, and try to get buckets on the other end. Thanks for all your work with the program, David. Appreciate you. Asher. There is a reason that Asher was voted as a captain. And I was so happy when I saw the team vote him as captain because they were right on, they were spot on. Asher is a man that has extremely high character and is an extremely hard worker. When he was on the court, it was energy time. He was able to pick us up when we were flat. He was able to force havoc with his pressure. But most of you didn't see his biggest contribution to the team because it happened with the practice jersey on. One of the reasons I believe that we got better at limiting our turnovers is because of the work that this man did against our other guards by playing scout team defense and being just crazy energetic and trying to get steals. It's not easy to do what he did, but I'm super proud of him for it. Ashley, I thank you for all your hard work for our program for the last 4 years, and I wouldn't want anyone else to go and train to defend our country than someone like you. I'm going to be proud of who you are and what you're going to be. Thanks for 4 years in our program. But. I still got two seniors left. Chris. Chris almost always had to guard the best player on the other team. It's funny because as a sophomore, Chris couldn't play defense at all. Helpside defense was a foreign language, and now he's checking some of the best players in our area. Chris is a great example to younger players that there are a lot of things that you can do on the court besides scoring to help your team win. Chris's athleticism on defense allowed us to have success, and Chris, again, I thank you for your 4 years in the program, and God's blessings to you as well. Lastly, the big guy in the middle, Joe. Joe is the unquestioned vocal leader of our team. He shows the ultimate team mentality, and it showed through this year. As roles developed throughout the middle of the year, Joe's role probably was impacted more than any other. I was asking my leading scorer from last year to have a much less role in the scoring column. I went and talked to him one night before a game, and I wanted to explain to him why we're doing it, because I didn't want to pull the rug out from under his feet. And his response was, I'm paraphrasing, but he said, Coach, you don't need to even explain it. I'm all in. Whatever is best for the team. If that doesn't show teamwork and leadership, I don't know what does. As a coach, it's humbling to see your athletes deal with situations better than you did when you were a teenager, and Joe's a great example of that. Like all the others I just mentioned, Joe, I'm proud of who you have grown up to be. You represent everything that makes our program great, and I wish you guys blessings as you go on from here in a couple months. Thanks, Joe. one is the Defensive Player of the Year. This award goes to a player who knew his defensive contributions are probably the best way that he impacted the game for us. Being asked on a nightly basis to cover guys who are scoring on average 20 to 45 points a game is not easy, and I'm not exaggerating. Actually, it was 46 the Ellington guy scored the night before he played us. Despite all this, he gave a tremendous effort to contain those studs, and therefore our Defensive Player of the Year is Chris Schlecht. Most improved is the next one. In a season of serious growth and improvement, picking out singular efforts is challenging. This season would not have been what it was if not for the significant work of many. And we are going to recognize one player for the most improvement since last season and one for the most improvement during the course of the season. The player who is the most improved since last season is Logan Lawson. Logan set goals a year ago and set out to accomplish them. He worked so hard to get his body into playing shape so that he could see more court time and a much bigger role on the team. Needless to say, hard work pays off. I know his parents are really proud of his transformation, and I'm really proud of his work ethic. Our most improved since last year, Logan Lawson. He knew his strengths, and he utilized them. His shooting accuracy was evident throughout the year, to the point that when he shot, myself, the team, and even our fans were surprised when he missed. For him to be doing all these things as only a sophomore is awesome. Our most improved this year throughout the season, Ethan Jensen. Newcomer of the Year. Our Newcomer of the Year this year is Ethan Russell. I know many of you are shocked by this, but that's how the team voted. When Ethan started the season, his skill set and basketball IQ were evident. My biggest questions were how he would react to playing against 18-year-old grown men, especially down low where it's physical. There is a steep learning curve for varsity, and Ethan took on that challenge. I kept throwing more and more responsibility at him as he was up to the challenge every night. In the second half of the season, Ethan was guarded by the best athlete on the opposing team on a nightly basis, and he just accepted that challenge too. I know that he is fun to watch in the stands, and I can honestly say it's really fun to coach him on this side of the line. Our newcomer of the year, Ethan Russell. Most valuable player. Value is hard to quantify at times. I try to think of it as this. If we don't have this player on the team, how would we function? There were two players that split the votes really evenly this year, and so we will do two MVPs tonight. The first award goes to a leader on our team who was a playmaker, but if you asked him, he would tell you that he enjoys setting up a play for a teammate even more. That said, he had plenty of his own moments. It always seemed like the ball found him in crunch time, and he delivered again and again. His ability to get our offense set up and running is also a huge reason why the first MVP of the night goes to Andrew Heil. The second MVP goes to another playmaker. As the season went on, he appeared to figure this whole varsity thing out. Teammates kept looking for him to knock down shots both inside and out. His court savvy at his age is something that is truly remarkable. To say that I am proud of his growth this season and extremely excited about this young man's potential is possibly the biggest understatement I can make. The second MVP award goes to Ethan Russell. Panther Award. One thing I enjoy about this school and my opportunity here to work with these young student athletes is recognizing how many people could win this award on a yearly basis. And as is the case most years, this could have gone to a number of people this year as well. This young man is exactly the kind of person you want to represent your program. His leadership, joy for the team, and love for his teammates are just the tip of the iceberg as to why our Panther Award this year goes to Joe Tischer. This weekend, our conference published the all-conference team, and so I'm able to share the results. Because it's so fresh, I don't have any hardware to hand out, but I would like to recognize those that were selected. This is selected by the conference coaches, not our own individual team or teammates, but we had one person that was able to be recognized by the conference this year. And so five individuals from the conference made the first team and five made the second team, and on the second team this year, our very own Ethan Russell. I don't have it. I'll give it to you when I get it. Congratulations. I have a couple of numbers I'd like to share with you before I wrap up my time here. This year we were able to have several individuals, student athletes that were able to crack the top 10 in specific statistical categories, and I was somewhat surprised by the results, and I'd like to read them off real quick for you, and when I say your name, just stand up and we'll embarrass you. The first is Andrew. I should say that I don't have every single season's statistics. I'm scouring all over the place. But if you are watching this, or if you know people from, let me find it here real quick, the 2006, 2007, or 2009 seasons, I would love to get my hands on the stats so I can have everything completed. But based on everything that I have, here are some of our individuals that I'd like to recognize. Andrew had 55 assists this year, which was the 10th best for an individual season. Not done. Andrew made 39 threes this year. That was the 4th best season in program history. And his 3-point percentage of 34.8, almost 35, was the 7th best in the season. So congratulations, Andrew. Nathan. Bet you weren't expecting this. Nathan had 7 blocks this year, which ties him for 9th. Congratulations, Nathan. Sam. Sam amassed 113 rebounds, which is the 10th best season of all time, and his 29 made 3-pointers is 9th best all time. There's that Nick Hansen guy on the list. You should try to get there someday. Congratulations, Sam. Ethan Jensted. I said I was surprised when he missed. I meant it. He shot 39.5% from 3. Almost got to 40 this year. Ethan, that's 4th best all time. Congratulations. Ethan Russell. Ethan shot a lot of free throws, and he made a lot of them. To the tune of 73.6%. That's the 5th best percentage in a singular season. He also scored 262 points this year, which was the 10th best season points for an individual person. And with 28 blocks this year, Ethan had the highest number in an individual season. This is something special that's happening right here. It's palpable. People that are associated with basketball around this area can see what's happening here, and I can't wait to see where we can go from here. We are going to need more players to step up and take on a bigger role next year, and our program needs to specifically improve in areas like defense, training hard every day so we can handle intense programs that try to put pressure in our face, and obviously we must continue to develop our skills. Let's keep that momentum going, and with focus and intentionality, so that next year is even more fun. I am truly blessed to be able to call these guys my team, and as always, Panther Proud. Unless I'm forgetting anything, and feel free to interrupt me if I am, we'll be taking a couple more pictures of the basketball awards, and then everyone that's won in a trophy or a plaque this evening, and Lloyd will be taking care of that probably right behind here, I'm guessing, right? Students, don't forget to pick up your certificates in the allotted rooms. I think cheerleaders are in 129. I don't know if that was mentioned or not. Brief commercial. Please make sure that you put in your calendars the spring production.
Yeah!
Secret Garden. Secret Garden, fun, magic, and lots of good stuff. Right, Mrs. Yeager?
Right.
All right. I believe the dates are April 3rd, 4th, and 5th. It's the first weekend of April. 2nd, 3rd, 4th, something like that. Please come and check out our kids that are going to be involved in that. They're working on getting that ready as well. So students, make sure you take care of getting certificates and things like that. I will reiterate what I said earlier. If this is your first letter, talk to Mrs. Arndt tomorrow in the office. We'll get you your Chanel. Thank you to all of you that were able to come this evening or are watching online. And what I said at the beginning is, I'll reiterate as well. It does take a village, and we really do appreciate what you've been able to do as far as putting your children in our care. We don't take that opportunity lightly, and I thank you